Good morning, children. Today we are here to learn a new topic. That topic is very much familiar to you. But in beginning only, I am not going to give you any introduction of the topic. Afterward, you have to come to the conclusion on what topic we people are discussing. Many a time, recreation was many a time for the recreation. You people go for this movie, that movie, or that. But when I was small, at that time, recreation was only granny and grandpa. They used to tell us their real life stories. Real life stories. They used to plot everything according to the sequence over there. In the same way, student, the story writing what we are learning today is that only, student. You have to keep in your mind that story writing had got certain criteria. If you want to write a story writing in a very correct form, student, you have to keep the following things in your mind. Otherwise, your story will be very shabby. You have to have a whole plot clear in your mind as you're writing the story. The main point arranged in a proper order. Remember, student, the main point on which what you are writing. A plot of each story is giving you a more or less in the outline provided to your student. Remember, student, this outline is just like a skeleton. To this skeleton, you have to put a flesh as well as you have to breathe life into it over there. Children, you must have tried to produce. You have to try to produce a connective narration and to make it interesting as you can, student. Remember, following hints you have to keep in your mind as you are writing the story. The first one is what? Clear idea of the plot of the story over there. As it has been told to you, student, see that you have a clear idea about what you are writing in your brain, okay, before writing. Follow the outline, student. Whatever outline is given, student, that outline has to be strictly followed. You are not supposed to leave any of the point. Otherwise, what will happen? It will not going to create any connectivity over there. Be careful to connect the point given in the outline as naturally, so that whole will be read as connecting to each other. Okay, and it will be like a good comprehension over there. Otherwise, it will be not getting connected to each other and it will be very shabby and it will not be very interesting for the person who is trying to read, student. Okay, whatever outline is given, try to put something, try to put your imagination in that outline. Plus, when you are putting it, you can put your gestures, what you are going to give when you are having conversation in between two characters in the story over there, student. Okay. Then another point is what, student? Conclusion. That conclusion point is very important, student. The whole story should be made to let up naturally, and then it should be come as bit of the surprise, student. Okay. Now regarding the heading, what type of heading should be given? See, if suppose you are asked to put a heading, student, the heading can be given on the base of the important character of the story. Now take the example, if suppose I say, come on, please write down the story about Shivaji Maharaj over there, or any incident that turned the life of Shivaji Maharaj over there, yes or no? And you have put all the plots, you have put all the plots, everything correctly. And what will be the title? It will be the great Shivaji Maharaj over there, yes or no, student? If suppose while coming back to the house, you met an accident over there, and if suppose somebody asks, please write the incident that took place in your life today in the form of the story, what type of heading you're going to give? It's quite natural, it will be heading, student. It will be like an accident, student. This heading can be also given in the form of proverbs as well as a famous quoting. Now take the example, no pain, no gain. This is also one proverb, student. Okay. Another one is what? When you are in Rome, be like a Rome over there, student. Okay. Now the last point that I want to explain you is about what? Language and all. If suppose you have a composition, remember what composition you are making, what you are writing, student. It should be simple, easy and grammatically correct language, student. It may be Hindi also, it may be Marathi also, and it will be English also. Whatever points we people are completing, same points can be utilized for the other language also. Plus, as you have got all the points, all the plots clear to you, revise it again and again when you are delivering, so that not a single plot or not a single point could be skipped. Otherwise, there will be no connectivity. It will going to create more impact, student. Okay, coming to the type of the story, students, stories are of two types. First one is of narration of a real event and imaginary event. Now, narration of a real event, student. Just now, I gave you the example of a Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, student. Yes or no, student? If I ask you to write something about him, quite naturally, it will be narration of a real event. That means whatever real event that took place at his time, it will be real. Quite naturally, it will going to come under the heading of what? Real event. Imaginary event. Now, if suppose I ask you, come on, you have to write one beautiful story by considering yourself that you're going to become a Prime Minister of Free Republic India, student. It will be one kind of imagination. No, that's all. Okay. Now, following head points that you have to keep in your mind. The very first one, beginning. All of you know it very well, student. Imaginary stories. Imaginary story. Long, long ago, there was a beautiful princess named Kasturi. Unfortunately, she was caught by dash, dash, dash. Then you can illustrate over there. Around that princess, all those who are the characters, then you have to introduce one by one. Plus, you have to make a connection of that characters with each other, then form a plot, and then what will be the crucial time comes that will going to create climax. Plus, you have to put a moral, what type of moral you people are getting from the story, student. From examination point of view, student, let me tell you, this point, this topic comes in a section B, writing and writing skills and a grammar section over there. It comprises of what? 10 marks. It comprises of what? 10 marks. One photo I'll be providing you, student, that is the correct format of the story writing, the title of the story, content of the story, character of the story, setting of the story, plot of the story, and then the end. No doubt you have to write moral also, student. Okay, that's all in this topic. But before that, I want to tell you, in the very next period, we'll be providing you the PDF. In that PDF, few topics will be given. That topic you have to understand well and you have to develop the story. Okay, in the next slides, there are different type of examples. You have studied these examples, I explain you. Before this also, I explain you, student, that stories can be written in the form of a narrative event and imaginary event. I have given you three slides. In that three slides, you will understand that stories, it can be written in the proverb also. Plus, there is one situation on that situation. What type of imaginary things will going to come in your mind, it can be also written. Third one example that I want to put in front of you is that what? One picture will be given. You have to predict your imagination and you have to derive one story based on that picture, student. This is what in this lecture. Thank you.